Highest hash rate. Home use. Bitcoin miner. Welcome to the Woyu channel. Today we received the newest member of the Avalon family, Avalon Q. It is a home use silent miner for mining BTC. So far, the home use silent miner with the largest hash rate is this one. Let us open it and see what is inside. A very sturdy packaging. Let us first look at its accessory box section. One mining pool card. One manual. One power supply. The power supply specification is a 10 ampere interface paired with a 16 ampere tail. Here is a Wi-Fi receiver. These are its feet pads. It is equipped with 4 anti-slip feet pads. If needed, you can stick them on yourself. Then we take out the unit itself to look at. This machine is somewhat heavy. The official outer packaging states weight with packaging is 14.7 kilograms. Bare unit weight is 11.2 kilograms. After weighing it, with packaging it is approximately 14.55 kilograms. After weighing the bare unit, its weight is actually 11.26 kilograms. When you receive the goods, all the equipment is here. Avalon always provides very complete accessories. You do not need to worry about whether there is a power cord or whether there are Wi-Fi issues. This is the confidence I have always had in Avalon. Friends who mine regularly know the biggest problem with mining machines is that the air intake and exhaust vents are very prone to dust accumulation. On this point, starting from the Nano 3, Avalon has consistently implemented dust filter designs. The exhaust vent of the Avalon Q still has a dust filter design, and this dust filter is detachable and washable. The entire Avalon product family all come standard with dust filters, making your miner easy to maintain and keeping it free from dust troubles at home. Let us look at the control panel of the Avalon Q. The leftmost is a power button. Press and hold it to turn it on or put it into standby mode. If you press it twice, it can switch between normal mode, economy mode, and super mode. Next to it is a reset button. Then you press and hold it to reset the mining machine. For example, if you need to change the Wi-Fi, you can achieve it by pressing and holding it. In the middle is a display panel. Later, after we power it on, you can see your IP address and other information. This is the interface for the Wi-Fi module. Both the Avalon Q and Nano 3 seconds have introduced this Wi-Fi Bluetooth. You just need to plug it in, and then you can enable your Wi-Fi function. Simultaneously, an Ethernet port is also equipped. For friends who prefer to use Ethernet cables, you can also directly use the Ethernet port. It supports both Wi-Fi and Ethernet connection methods. The back of the Avalon Q is relatively simple. Just an on or off switch and a power input port. Its power supply supports 100 to 240 volt voltage. Usable worldwide. In terms of cooling, the Avalon Q incorporates two 120 millimeter fans. They are silent fans. We take out the Bluetooth Wi-Fi module. Plug it into the Bluetooth port. If you want to use Ethernet, then find a network cable and connect it to the Ethernet port. Then we connect the power cord. Must remember to plug it in securely. Check the power cord properly. There must be no poor contact or looseness. Now I will demonstrate how to connect the Avalon Q. First, we need to download the Avalon Family application. If Android needs the installation package, you can come to our Woyu TG group. We have the direct installation package, saving you the trouble of downloading it. First, we open the Avalon Family application. Click the three bars in the upper right corner. Click New and search. You will then search and find your Avalon Q. Click Connect to connect. Then now you can go to match your Wi-Fi. You select the Wi-Fi you want to use, and after entering the correct password, click Save. At this point, the Avalon Q has successfully configured Wi-Fi. If you do not need to change the password, you can just go back. Next, we demonstrate how to configure the mining pool. You can go through Setting. Click Pool Config. Here is the mining pool address. You just need to input the pool you want. If you need the machine to perform solo mining, you can turn on this solo mode logo. It should optimize your solo mode to some extent. We enter the Avalon Q interface. Here, change the name of your machine. If you have multiple machines, it is convenient for your management. Here you can set the room where you placed it. Living room, bathroom, bedroom, or office are all fine. In the third column, we can see it has economy mode, standard mode, and super mode. Three modes to choose from. In the timer here, you can also set an on and off countdown timer. If at night you find it noisy or too hot, and you do not want it turned on, you can set it here. In setting, the first is the password option. If you do not need to change the password, ignore it. The second is mining pool change. The third item is the dust filter cleaning level reminder. Then you can also calibrate its time zone. That is, if your machine has any problems, you can submit your work ticket here. You can also use your mobile phone to set its power on and off. It should be noted that using the Avalon Family application, the machine and mobile phone to be on the same Wi-Fi network. Next, for convenience, I will use a computer to demonstrate how to configure the mining pool. First, you need to confirm the miner's Wi-Fi and the computer's Wi-Fi or Ethernet are on the same network. We see the IP address displayed on the screen above. We input the IP address into your browser. At this point, the Avalon backend is opened. There are two ways to log into the backend. The first is through the Avalon Family application to scan QR code to log in. The second is to input its password. Generally, its default password is admin. We click login. Now you have entered its backend. I take ViaTC as an example. After you log into your account, we click the pool in the upper right corner. Go to the dashboard. Select the coin you want. I take Bitcoin as an example. Here is the Bitcoin address. Click to copy it. Here is the pool config. We directly paste the address we just copied here. The worker name is your username on ViaTC. If you have multiple devices, you can add a dot and then input your device number or sequence or IP address. Password filled in randomly, then click Submit. The mining machine will restart to configure the mining pool. After it restarts successfully, it will automatically return to your configuration interface. If you want to change your work mode, you need to change it from within your Avalon Family app. Now Avalon Q has been running for about 15 minutes. We are using super mode. Its hash rate is about 93. Now let us try switching to standard mode. After you operate standard mode on your mobile phone, your web interface will also switch to standard mode synchronously. We ran standard mode for about 10 minutes. Hash rate was 79.83, nearly 80 tera hashes. Power consumption dropped to about 1,360 watts. Let us try eco mode. We switch to eco mode on the mobile phone. Then we wait another 10 minutes. After switching to eco mode and running for 10 minutes, hashrate was about 53.92. Power consumption dropped to 829 watts. Summarize this machine. The machine has been running for about 15 hours. Current hash rate is about 93 terahashes per second. Power consumption is stable at 1,690 watts. We placed the tester 30 centimeters away from the exhaust vent. Its decibel level is below about 50 decibels, less than 50 dB. It is a very silent machine. Its exhaust temperature is controlled at about 58 degrees Celsius. Surface temperature is less than 40 degrees Celsius. Compared to ordinary mining machines, it is already very suitable for home use. In terms of noise and temperature, it is very suitable for home use. We measured its dimensions. It should be suitable for placement in a 3-unit rack. If you have one at home or your own rack setup, placing it in the rack to mine is also perfect. Let us summarize the performance of the Avalon Q's 3 modes. In super mode, it can reach 90 terahashes per second. Power consumption reaches 1,680 watts. Noise is about 50 decibels. In standard mode, it can reach about 80 terahashes per second hash rate. Power consumption is 1,360 watts. Noise is about 42 decibels. In eco mode, hash rate will drop to 53. Power consumption will drop to 829 watts, about 40 decibels. We have finally gathered the complete Avalon family, a complete family neatly arranged. This Avalon Q from the Avalon family. Its hash rate is 90 terahashes per second. We just tested it. Super mode can reach about 92 to 93 terahashes per second. This floor heating miner, we also reviewed previously. Its hash rate is 37.5. Then these two lottery miners in front are the Nano 3. Nano 3, its hash rate is 4 terahashes. Nano 3 seconds, its hash rate is 6T. Their total combined hash rate reaches a terrifying 137.5 terahashes. If you are interested, you can gather these four and place them at home for mining. Avalon Q is a silent home-use Bitcoin miner. This is beyond doubt. At the same time, it is also the home-use Bitcoin miner with the largest hash rate. If you are interested in the Avalon Q or other models, welcome to our WoW channel or TG group to get the latest mining machine information daily and the most favorable prices.